Hi folks, Peach Mario here again with the next video about community communications. And the next topic is a new governance model, a proposal how it could look like. I did have a look at other open source projects. Most of them are big, but they have a lot of overhead. I wanted something which is very sleek and similar to what we have already. So. Starting here again from the proposed main page, there is a link which I said how to contribute, and it's called community info. In the end, all of this information should land somewhere here. It should be under text. But now, for the beginning, we need something to discuss, and there we have a repository which I called a committee. Which contains the basic informations. And most of the text I actually copied over from WebOS, the open source edition, because they started a very new project. They are starting to build up their community, and they have a very open and a very sleek governance model. So here is contributing, and a lot of the text is copied over, and it's not a problem because it is Creative Commons. So I borrowed a lot of this text and modified it to work with TillyWiki, so to get let's say a little bit of a head start. So the first element is the README. So as what's very important, everything here is work in progress. And it's made to be discussed. So there is some description about how can someone join the community. So if you are really a new user, you may want to have a new feature. So you have the feature request, which we discussed already. There's the feature request board, so new users can get a fast overview. Then new users can check out the different repositories and maybe open the requirements. So there is some information about requirements. There is a link to the different repositories, which I will discuss in detail. So this is, for example, for developers, interesting for developers. Then discuss your ideas. The idea discussion is part of the feature request section, which goes back to the feature requests. So that's the way how everything is linked together. And then there is the, let's say, the important stuff for this part, which is called the governance model, which defines some basic rules. And as I said, I really wanted to have it as simple as possible. So at the moment, everything in the different repositories cannot be merged if there is a discussion pending. So at the moment, it's 100% consensus model for the developers, which is not very practical, but at the beginning, I just set it as default. So there is a little bit about information about the organization, how TillyWiki.org, I use TillyWiki.org, I hope we can get it there. Uses the BSD3 license, which is part of TillyWiki, so this is the code, and we use the Creative Commons 3 license for our documentation. And also this documentation should work with this license. Then there is the communication process with the different forums, which will be another video. The forums, there is the feature request forum, there is a chat, which we proposed already, it's Gitter. If I open it, it's a third-party library, but we have already some communications going on here with the TillyWiki public chat. This is also a request that came very often. I personally would like to have a voice chat. So having a text chat and a voice chat, for me, it would be nice. So that's why I did create a Discord account and set up a Discord server. And we have the TillyWiki discussion group that's already known. So the different forums. Then there is a little bit of information about how we accept contributions. So this is, let's say, the very basics. It's a step-by-step information. It also covers the contributor's license agreement. It covers the review process, consensus seeking, and so on. So this is definitely part for improvement and discussion. So nothing here is carved in stone. But we need a starting point to start discussion. So the how we accept contributions, and then there is a little bit about the community guidelines, which I also wanted to have very, very simple. There are big open source projects where they have pages and pages of information how you should not behave, which is not interesting for me. I would like to have some information how we should behave, and keep it as simple as possible. Definitely some room for improvement, but as a starting point, I think it works. Yeah, that's the basic information. You should take your time, and from the proposed landing page, there will be a link which will lead you there, and then you can have a look at the different elements. As I said, at the moment I'm using this repository which is called Committee. There is a new structure which is called tillywiki.org. Then I called it Senatus, use Wikipedia to see what it means, and then Committee. And this is the repository where everything is stored at the moment. And if you want to be a user, just fork it and create merge requests, so we can change the stuff. Yeah, that's the basics for the governance model. Next video will be about a little bit more about consensus seeking, because I need input, the possibilities we have, and see you soon.